And I know what you see in me. You see the truth, see the me in me. You see enough to believe in me. You see your son, but is he in me?
With the road in light, where the slang is engraved, with the slaver language, in the streets of bay, with the pain of slave ships. Still I submit to it, falling still through it. How can I never get a fit through it? I see heaven at the end, I'm trying to get to it. Scared to get lost and I admit to it, so I stick to it. This routine, me and my constituents gotta...
Dude, you're alive.
I'm off the phone. That's a first today. Tell the vlog what's happening. I started the day. Colin had a doctor's appointment at 8:30. Last year on the vlog, he broke his arm. This year, not pictured on the vlog, but during the filming of the vlog, he broke his arm. So last Thursday night, we had a nice little emergency room visit. Today, I had to go get him casted. So that was how the day started. Teddy got his workout in. I came home. I've literally been on calls nonstop since 10:30. Haven't had any breaks at all. It's now 4:30, so we're gonna go get a quick workout in. Gonna hit the Global Gym today. Yesterday we did a pretty intense workout at CrossFit, deadlifts and lateral burpees and running. So I know that I hit my CNS pretty hard and I need to be smart and not, like I think at CrossFit today it's programmed like a heavy squat clean and then a lot of squat cleans and toes to bar, and it would have gotten pretty nervous system intensive for me. So I need to be smart. Just go get a pump, go do some upper body pressing. I don't even know what I'm gonna do, but it'll be good. And then I gotta come home and I gotta, it's a crazy night in our house. Colin has a band performance. Ella has some performance at her school. I don't even know what the fuck it's for. And Jackson has soccer practice. And we have a newborn in the house. So that's just kind of how you roll. You know, fortunately, with it being in season, I really am prioritizing myself. So I have gotten in 3 meals already today. And I'm gonna get this workout in. I'm gonna get some recovery in. I'm gonna prioritize my sleep. Tomorrow's gonna probably be an off day for me. I think I've got a pretty busy day. I have a call with my publisher. So, you know, just doing what I can to maximize myself. Like I told you guys on day one, that's what this season is about for me. It's finding that balance. And hopefully you guys can see, even if you have a lot going on, you can get it done. It's just about structure. I'll do a little voiceover for them on this workout. So we'll get Teddy to film all of the working out, and then I'll just do a voiceover, kind of tell you about the movements I'm doing. I know a lot of you guys are familiar with the CrossFit setting, so it'll be cool for me to break things down, tell you kind of my thought process behind how I put together upper body push workouts, and we'll take it from there. All right, guys, stay with me. First voiceover, but as you can see, I'm starting with a one-arm dumbbell press. I love the unilateral variation here. Obviously, adds a stability component, but really allows you to engage the working muscle as well. We built up to, I believe it was 95 pounds for 8 reps each arm, which ended up being, I think it was 3 or 4 actual working sets. And then from there, we transitioned downstairs to the incline hammer strength machine. Now, as you guys know, in bodybuilding work, we chase the pump. We're not really super looking to overload. So the weight wasn't super heavy, but that constant contraction really adds to the fatigue, really creates a nice pump. I use this in almost every quote-unquote chest workout that I do. So 4 sets, I think it was 8 reps each arm. Maybe we went as high as 10. Last chest movement in this sequence was the traditional cable crossover. As you guys can see, not going super fast, not using super heavy weight, really controlling, really making sure I'm isolating the working muscle, really trying to squeeze, and it definitely put me into a good position. Now, after this, we go into a vertical press. So I chose the Philly press. I've taken this from Marcus Philly. Obviously, one arm stabilizing in that front rack, the other arm pressing. Really good movement, really allows me to work on the stability. You can see me trying to keep my rib cage down. And then finally, guys, the final, I guess, pressing movement would be the dip. I like to finish most upper body pressing sessions with 100 dips. Now I was tight for time on this day, so I ended up getting 94 sets, 25, 25, 20, 20.
And then the other finisher I like doing, you're about to see, is a triceps extension. So on this day, I chose the dumbbell skull crusher. Typical Global Gym at night, all the cables were taken, so I chose a dumbbell skull crusher, 4 sets, 10 to 12. There you have it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the workout. Give it a go. Let me know your thoughts. All right, guys, just finished up the gym. You guys just heard the voiceover and pretty much everything I do in the workout. As you can tell, the end was a little bit rushed. Guys, at the end of the day, I'm a dad first, I'm a husband first, I'm a business owner first. My own stuff comes second. I told you I was gonna prioritize getting into the gym. I didn't say I was gonna maximize my time while there. It's just a sacrifice I'm willing to make. I've come to peace with it. So the reality is now it's 5:50. Like we said earlier, all three kids are in different places. Teddy's been gracious enough to take Jackson to soccer. So I'm gonna take Colin to his band thing. Paige is gonna take Ella to her little recital or play or whatever they're doing at school. And then we're gonna wrap up the night. I fortunately don't have any phone calls tonight, so just gonna be a quick night of getting some food, answering emails, keeping it chill. Guys, I swear I would vlog more often if we didn't have 10 million things going on and if my life was not so fucking boring. I think so many people think I have like this super glamorous, really fun life. Like I wish my vlog was like Christian or Max, like where they did shit all the time, but their success comes with a lot of fun. My success comes with just monotony, which is okay. Like, it's the process, it's the same thing over and over. I wouldn't have it any other way. I think that like creating impact is far different than how they make their money, which is totally fine. Like, not in any way poo-pooing on how they make their money. Like, I think that they both have really successful brands. I respect them a lot as brand builders. In fact, I think if you've heard me recently talk about the state of business, I believe becoming an influencer first is the best business model you can have. So mad props to all the people crushing it on YouTube. But for me, it's an impact proposition. And the only way I know how to create impact is to create education and to create implementation. And for those things, it's just day in, day out, phone calls, emails, client interaction. Yes, we get to travel to do that sometimes. And so you guys see some fun trips, but when we're home, it's wake up, talk some more, finally get to the gym, spend some time with my family, and then go to sleep.
Cookies.
And cookies, always. Well, this week it's been cupcakes.
Nice, yeah.
This week it's been cupcakes from Georgetown Cupcakes. Shout out to everyone that came to the level one.
And Tia Toomey was in there. She made one of the best statements that so many people missed. She woke up on Sunday morning and she said, I can't wait till I don't have to eat all this food. But she understood that she had to fuel herself and she had to recover.
Mike, I could totally picture you as an actress, so that's, I feel like you at least like hit it on the head when you were picturing where you were gonna be in life, but I think that you obviously found a purpose that was far deeper than what you could do on the big screen.
Application based, and that's not how we do anything. From the core tenets of NCI or IN3 all the way into the mastermind, I don't want you guys to walk out of here just like woo-woo, like I'm really happy and I'm really motivated and this is what I'm gonna get done in the next 3 months, and then you go home and like you look at your computer and you're like, fuck, where do I even start? And I've spent thousands of dollars, if not tens of thousands of dollars, going to events. And that was the feeling I got. I went home, I was super excited, people got me super hyped and super motivated, and I didn't even know what the fuck to do. So our goal, when you guys walk out of the door tomorrow night, is you're gonna know what you wanna achieve by the next time we meet in Vegas, and more importantly, how are we gonna get there? Obviously, by being in this room, you're getting on phone calls with us bi-weekly, and those bi-weekly phone calls will be exactly how we get you guys to those goals. So, you know, we'll talk about the macro this weekend, but we'll implement on the micro over the next several weeks.